Well, good morning. And happy 4th of July weekend to all of you. I hope you have an opportunity to celebrate on the 4th. I'm Pastor Nanette Christofferson, and along with Pastor Steve Talmadge, who's out on vacation, we want to welcome you to our 9 o'clock contemporary worship service, both in person and online as well. Just a few announcements as we get started this morning. Pastor Steve will be back on Wednesday, and if you need help with anything and it can wait, no, I'm just kidding. If you need anything, please let us know. We're happy to help, and I'm happy to help however I can. We have just a few announcements with Grace in the City. Our water, we're continuing to donate water through the month of July. These go to homeless, those who are experiencing homelessness in downtown Phoenix at the Lutheran church there called Grace in the City. This is a service that they offer respite care in the summers, Monday through Friday. It's a lot for a community to offer respite care for the homeless, and they have been experiencing a lot of homeless people, and so this water is needed. And so if you'd like to donate money to this, you may do so, and you can put it in the offering plate. Just label it as water money for Grace, and we will make sure it gets to where it needs to go. Backpacks. It's time to start thinking about school, and we'll be collecting backpacks and school supplies throughout the month of July. We'd like it heavy on the early side if you can bring your goods next week, as we're asking that the Vacation Bible School kids will be packing the backpacks so that they will be ready for children this year. This goes to La Masita's Family Shelter and also to local elementary schools. So please bring in school supplies sometime this week. And if you wait and bring them at the end of July, we'll use them then too. So just know that whenever you bring them, we will put them to use. We'll also be collecting clothes for kids next week. You'll see a cactus in the narthex with little notes on it. You can grab a note, and on the note, it will give you the name, not the name of a child, but the age of a child, and what size they are, and whether they're male or female, and you can buy new clothes for them for school. This will go to Lutheran Social Services for their back to school so that children in need will have some new clothes this year. VBS is almost here next week. We will start it next Monday, July 10th through the 14th, and we have volunteers in place, which is wonderful. But if you'd like to come and help out in the morning and just see what's going on, we'd love to have you come. So if there's a morning that you'd like to come, just let me know, and we'll get you going, and you can see what's going on. And we ask that you sign the purple books that are right there, and please sign your name, and welcome anyone whom you don't know. Communion, we'd like to invite all to communion. Gluten-free wafers are in the center of the bread plate, and there's grapefruit in the center of the drink tray. All who are baptized are welcome to the table. Let us now prepare our hearts and minds as we get ready to worship God. Please stand.
Good morning. It is written, "Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world." We will sing that today.
Bring your tithe and bring your shame. Bring your guilt and bring your pain. Don't you know that's not your name? You will always be much more than me. Every time I wrestle with the voices that keep telling me I'm not right, but that's all right. But I hear a voice and he calls me redeemed. But others say I'll never be enough. Greater is the one living inside of me than he who is living in the world. In the world. In the world. Oh yeah. Greater is the one living inside of me than he who is living in the world.
Bring your doubts and bring your fears. Bring your hurt and bring your tears. There'll be no condemnation here. You are holy, righteous, and redeemed. Every time I fall, there'll be some voices to tell me that I'm a mistake. But that's okay, cause I hear the voice and he calls me redeemed. Where others say I'll never be enough. Greater is the one living inside of me than he who
There are days I lose the battle. Grace says that it doesn't matter, cause if God says already won the war. I'm learning to run freely, understand just how he sees me, and it makes me love him even more. There are days I lose the battle. Grace says that it doesn't matter, cause the cross already won the war. I'm learning to run freely, understanding just how he sees me, and it makes me love him more and more. I hear a voice and he calls me redeemed, when others say I'll never be enough. The greater is the one living inside of me than he who is living in the world, in the world. In the world.
Greater. He is greater. Now we're going to sing the Lord's Prayer. It is yours. The Lord's Prayer.
Father, let your kingdom come. Father, let your will be done on earth as in heaven, right here in my heart. Father, let your kingdom come. Father, let your will be done, right earth as in heaven, right here in my heart. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us, lead us not into temptation,
against us,
into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. Let your kingdom come. Father, let your kingdom come. Father, let your will be done on earth as in heaven, right here in my heart. Father, let your kingdom come. Father, let your will be done on earth as in heaven, right here in my heart. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us as we forgive the ones who sin against us. Forgive us and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. Father, let your kingdom come. It's yours, all yours. The kingdom, the power, the glory are yours. It's yours, all yours, all yours. The kingdom. The kingdom is yours. It's yours. It's yours. All yours. All yours. The kingdom, the power, the glory are yours. It's yours. It's yours. All yours. All yours. Forever and ever. The kingdom is yours. Father, let your kingdom come. Father, let your will be done on earth as in heaven, right here in my heart. Father, let your kingdom come. Father, let your will be done on earth as in heaven, right here in my heart. On earth as in heaven, right here in my heart.
Let us pray. Lord God, we gather here together in your name. And God, your kingdom is here and now, and it is yet to come. Help us to live into that. Help us to let go of our worldly ways and to embrace your ways of your kingdom. Bring to us your welcoming spirit of being Christ's messengers, of being his hands and feet and arms of compassion. May we truly represent the love of Christ. God, as we enter into this time of worship and praise, renew our spirits so that we may walk out of here assured and blessed by your community of love. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Would the children come forward for the children's sermon? A new friend today. I'm so glad you came up. It's nice to have you with us. And how are the rest of you doing?
Good.
Well, today Jesus uses a word a lot in his three verses that we have today. And that word is welcome. Do you know what welcome means? Mm-hmm. What does it mean, Devin?
We're friendly.
Yeah, friendly would be one way. Kind, right? Welcoming. If I say, Roman, I welcome you to worship, is that a good thing or a bad thing? Yeah, it's a good thing, isn't it? So I put welcome on this sign. Yeah, and I'd like you to help me with some words that are welcoming words. What might be a welcoming word? Would we say hello to someone? Would that be welcoming? Yeah, I think it would. Let's put hello up here in the corner. You will in a minute. I'll put a smiley face on that. All right. Hello. What else might we say to welcome someone?
Be kind.
We might be kind. How do we welcome people? Would I say, Roman, it's nice to meet you. Would that be welcoming? Yeah. So a handshake, right? What else might be welcoming? Yeah. I'll let you draw a hand on it later, okay? Handshake. Okay, I'm way out of practice. I haven't written on a board for a long time. PowerPoints are wonderful. So, handshake. What else? What about, do you ever greet somebody like this? A high five. Yeah. High five. How else might you greet someone? Could you give them a fist bump? Yeah, we'll put a fist bump down here. What about, you know, sometimes people are careful. They have to be careful. They can't just hug someone because they want to be careful of germs and things like that. Could you elbow bump somebody? Would that be a way to greet somebody? If I go, hey, Reese, nice to have you here. Would that make you feel welcome? Yeah, so maybe an elbow bump might be welcome too.
You can give them like cookies or something.
Right. All right, look at that. So you guys have come up with all different kinds of ways to greet someone and make them feel welcome. But if you just go like this, will that make them feel welcome?
No.
Maybe, but it helps if you say, hello, right? Or nice to have you with us, right?
Yeah.
Is welcoming important?
Yes.
Yeah, what happens if you're new someplace? Right, if you welcome someone, that might mean you want to be their friend, right? That's what we hope. Welcome is really important. So what we're going to do is I'm going to put the sign over there on the floor, and you guys can color it during service. Would that work? And then when you're done coloring it, you can go sit back down with your parents, and then we'll put the welcome sign up right before we have our invitation to the Holy Supper, okay? So before you go, let's pray, and then I'd like you to practice as you walk back to your area or go to a different area and maybe elbow or fist bump someone, okay?
Okay.
And welcome them. Not only just go like this, but go, hello, it's nice to have you with us, okay?
Okay.
All right, so let's pray.
Dear God,
help us
to remember
to be friendly,
to be kind,
to be open,
to others.
Remind us, Lord.
Remind us, Lord.
To welcome others.
To welcome others.
In your name.
In your name.
We pray.
We pray.
Amen. All right, so while you're fist bumping and welcoming others, we're going to ask the congregation to stand, and I'm going to move the poster over there. And after you fist bump a few people, you can go over there and color on it. Okay? All right. Please stand for the gospel acclamation and the reading of the gospel.
Shall we go? Hallelujah, Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Hallelujah, you have the words of eternal life.
Morning. The gospel is from Matthew chapter 10, verses 40 through 42. Glory to you, O Lord. Whoever welcomes you welcomes me, and whoever welcomes me welcomes the one who sent me. Whoever welcomes a prophet in the name of a prophet will receive a prophet's reward. And whoever welcomes a righteous person in the name of a righteous person will receive the reward of the righteous. And whoever gives even a cup of cold water to one of these little ones in the name of a disciple, truly I tell you, none of these will lose their reward. This is the gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated. I'd like to start off today by reading for you the Old Testament scripture reading that we have for this week's lectionary. It comes from Jeremiah chapter 28, verses 5 through 9. Then the prophet Jeremiah spoke to the prophet Hananiah, and in the presence of the priests and all the people who were standing in the house of the Lord, and the prophet Jeremiah said, "Amen. May the Lord do so. May the Lord fulfill the words that you have prophesied, and bring back to this place from Babylon the vessels of the house of the Lord and all the exiles. But listen now to this word that I speak in your hearing and in the hearing of all people. The prophets who preceded you and me from ancient times prophesied war, famine, and pestilence against many countries and great kingdoms. As for the prophet who prophesies peace, when the word of that prophet comes true, then it will be known that the Lord has truly sent the prophet." These words are words from Jeremiah 28, 5 through 9, but it's part, of course, of a bigger story. It's part of something that was happening quite a long time ago. In fact, in 594 BCE, this story took place. And this is what was happening. The Babylonians had taken over Judah, and they had just taken over parts of Jerusalem, but they hadn't totally conquered it yet. Many people were taken into exile, meaning as they're taken into exile, they're taken to Babylon. And King Nebuchadnezzar has them all there, using them however he wishes. He has set up kind of a puppet monarchy in Jerusalem. And as the people that are there, that are left behind, they are longing for things to be restored. They are longing for Jerusalem to go back to its glory. They are longing for a word of deliverance from God. At the temple, there's priests and people there, and in walks the prophet Hananiah. And Hananiah tells the people, he says to them, "I have good news. You will be free. The exiles will be set free. God has broken the bonds of the Babylonians." And as he's saying this, Jeremiah is walking into the temple with a yoke around his neck. And Jeremiah, as we heard just a few minutes ago, is reminding Hananiah of God's prophets. He's reminding them that usually when a prophet comes, they talk of war, pestilence, and famine. And that usually the prophet dares to tell God's truth of grief, of disappointment, of his people not repenting, of his people not listening, of his people not being patient, long-suffering, or even willing to sacrifice. Jeremiah brings another word to the people. He tells them that God has said that they need to hunker down, that this exile will go on for many years, and to know that that is the word of the Lord. Think of the welcome that Hananiah received from the people. They were welcoming him because he was bringing good news. Jeremiah is saying, well, we won't know if Hananiah's request is correct or what he says for another year or two, but you will find out that it's incorrect. I'd like you to think about Jeremiah's welcome. Do you think anyone offered Jeremiah a cup of cold water? Do you think anyone wanted Jeremiah to come over to their homes? How do we welcome? How do we welcome others when they share a different view? How do we welcome the other when the truth they speak isn't what we want to hear? I think our reading, our Old Testament reading today, guides us to think about how we welcome others. Would you please pray with me? Good and gracious God, we give you praise and thanks for the blessing of this day, for this moment, for this space, for this time, for our ears to be open, Lord, and our hearts to be ready to be written upon with your hand. God, guide us. Guide us as we enter into your word of welcome this day. Help us to look at welcome in a new way, through your eyes. Father, Spirit, Jesus, may the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be pleasing to you, our rock and our redeemer. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Grace and peace to you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. As we get started today, we see that we are in the final three verses of Matthew's learning and Jesus' teaching on the missionary discourse of the disciples. And in this, it seems that Jesus is bringing to light what it means to welcome and what it means to welcome others. If you didn't notice in the gospel reading, welcome was used six times. Anytime in three verses when a word is used a lot of times, I think that's note to the preacher, stop! Look at this and see what it has to say. So let's stop and take a look at what welcome meant to the first century Jewish community. Welcome wasn't something that one brought as an individual. They might come individually, but they were always representing their family or their group or their town. They were representative of a family group or a community. And so when they welcomed someone, they would welcome them in the name of their family, not in their individual name. Jesus today tells us that when we welcome one, I believe he's bringing to light that the disciples, as they are welcoming others, are being sent out as representatives of Christ. They are to bring the words to others, but the words they say come from Christ, for they are Christ's representatives. Jesus says, whoever welcomes you welcomes me, and whoever welcomes me welcomes the one who sent me, meaning that if you welcome the disciple, you're welcoming Jesus, you're welcoming God, you're welcoming the one who sent them. As we look to welcome, we often sometimes, well, I'm just going to put it in today's world, we might look at welcoming like ambassadors. like we are ambassadors of Christ. If we look to our nation has many ambassadors, and the ambassadors speak on behalf of our country to other countries. We are ambassadors of Christ. Paul tells us this in Corinthians, and Jesus sends his disciples out as representatives of Christ. And we can look to Martin Luther, and he would say that this is like having little Christ. We are little Christ. So as we look at that, what does it mean to welcome others? As we welcome others in the name of Christ, that means we are Christ's hands, feet, heart, and arms of compassion to the other. That's what Jesus is explaining to the disciples as they are representatives. They are to be representative of Jesus, of Jesus' teachings. That's why he sends them out with nothing, having them be totally reliant upon God. Jesus also goes on to say, whoever welcomes the prophet shall receive a reward. Whoever welcomes the righteous person shall receive a reward. And what Jesus here means by reward is a blessing. It doesn't mean a tangible something that you receive. It really means kind of like a spiritual, intangible blessing that God brings to you when you welcome the prophet or you welcome the righteous person. Jesus then goes on to say, whoever offers a cup of cold water to these little ones, meaning children, or also his disciples, will also receive a reward or a blessing. A cup of cold water in Palestine, when offered to someone in a hot, dusty setting, would be a way of welcoming someone else. A cup of cold water on our way outside today would also be a way of welcoming, since we are living in such heat right now, right? And there's nothing like that cup of cold water to show someone you care, to show someone you are welcomed. So what does this welcoming look like as we put it into practice? There's just a few stories I'd like to share with you that I've heard through the grapevine, through people at Love of Christ, and I'd like us to think about what welcoming means here. As we look to welcome, there was a woman who came to our 10:30 service this past winter, and as she came, she walked into, I call it like the sanctuary almost has two narthexes, but it's the one by the kitchen, and she walked in those doors by the kitchen, and as she walked in, she didn't really know where things were, and she kind of stood there, and the choir happened to be in the kitchen, and they were having coffee and treats, and they immediately saw she was looking for something, and they invited her in. They offered her a cup of cold water. Well, it may have been a cup of coffee, but metaphorically or figuratively here, you know what I'm saying. They talked with her, and they asked, of course, Jung was there too, and she had to ask if she sang, but she declined and said she wasn't a singer. But she said that she sat down, and as she sat down, with nobody sitting next to her, she felt welcomed. She felt welcomed already by the welcoming spirit of the choir. Didn't take her long to return to church another Sunday, and before long she was baking cookies for our cookie ministry, all because she was offered a cup of cold water, a cup of welcoming in a spirit of Christ. We have Bible studies, we have other events, outreach events in which people participate here on campus. And there are times when I see people welcoming others with that spirit, with that cup of cold water, welcoming them into the study, welcoming them to come sit by them. Because as people, if they're brave enough to come to a Bible study, then I sure hope that as they come in, they are welcomed. They are asked questions to show that we care about them. They are offered a cup of cold water. As we look to research, research shows in a survey of congregations of 80 congregations, all different sizes, they polled people and asked them why they go to church or why are they part of their church community. The number one response was because somebody welcomed them when they first came. The number two response was that worship service seemed welcoming. The number three response was that they felt like it was time to get back to community. And the fourth response was the welcomingness of the pastor and the sermon. Boy, that takes a load off of me. I don't think we often stop and think enough about how we are to be the arms, the hands, the feet of Jesus. We are to be his extension. We are his emissaries. We are his ambassadors. We are his representatives. Not only here at church in this building, but when we go out into the world. How do we welcome others? Are we welcoming them? Letting them see that we share the love of Christ. Now, with this and with all this good news of the ways I see this community welcome others, there's always a flip side, isn't there? There's always that flip side of someone who doesn't get welcome that summer, that Sunday. There's always the flip side of people, and this is a natural thing that we do. We often gear to say hello to the same people each Sunday. We often don't even look for somebody new. And if we don't have a lot of visitors, maybe we're not even looking to say hi to someone we don't know who attends this church. It's human nature. It is human nature for us to go back to the same people to say hello, to check in with them. It's work. It's work to think about, who can I talk to this week that I haven't talked to in a while? Who do I see at church every Sunday, but I haven't offered a wave, an elbow, a fist bump of welcome to them? I believe Jesus is calling us today to recognize the importance of welcome, and that we are being sent out to show the world that we are Christ's hands and feet and his arms of compassion. May God this week place someone on our hearts of whom we need to be that ambassador of Christ to. And as we enter into worship and as we leave worship this day, may you talk to someone you haven't talked to or greet them that you haven't greeted with the welcome of Christ's love. Amen. Please stand as we get ready to profess our faith through the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father, the Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
As we continue our worship, this is Living Waters.
Are you thirsty? Are you empty? Come and drink these living waters. Tired and broken, peace unspoken, rest beside these living waters. Christ is calling,
find refreshing at the cross of living waters. Lay your life down, all the old gone. Life is in these living waters. There's a river that flows with mercy and love, bringing hope to the city of our God. There is hope, do not fear anymore. Praise the Lord of living waters. Spirit moving, mercy washing, healing in these living waters. Lead your children to the shoreline. Life is in these living waters. There's a river that flows with mercy and love, bringing joy to the city of our God. There our hope is secure, do not fear anymore. Praise the Lord of living waters.
Take it, Mike.
Thirsty, are you empty? Come and drink these living waters. Lord, forgiveness, vast and boundless, Christ, He is this living waters. There's a river that flows with mercy and love, bringing joy to the city of our God. There our hope is secure, do not fear anymore. Praise the Lord of living waters. There our hope is secure, do not fear anymore. Praise the Lord of living waters.
You may be seated. With the whole people of God in Christ Jesus, let us pray for the church, those in need, and all of God's creation. Lord, in your mercy, for wisdom to heed the voices of prophets in our midst, who cast a vision of God's promised future, for courage to welcome people whom society rejects, for resolve to serve all in need. Lord, in your mercy, for all bodies of water, rivers, lakes, oceans, and streams, for lands experiencing scorching heat, drought, and wildfire, for scientists working on clean energy and solutions, Lord, in your mercy, for our nation, for thankfulness for this place we call home in the United States of America, for all that it has given us. Guide us in ways of freedom that promote for the common good, Lord. Lord, in your mercy. For those who are ill, we lift up this week Elaine, Doris, Rayanne, Priscilla, Fran, Rod, Kate, Agnes, Dennis, Kim, Kirk, Larry, Christina, Doug, Ken, Red, and Kit. We lift up Pam, Jackie, Judy, Debbie, Don. Lord God, we pause now and lift up all who are on our hearts. Lord, may your arms of compassion wrap around them. May they bring them your hope, your comfort, and your healing presence. Lord, in your mercy. For children, and for our preschool children, for their safety at home and in childcare settings, for their flourishing at summer programs and camps, for the many people who care for them, including parents and grandparents, childcare workers and teachers, coaches, counselors, mentors, pediatricians, and psychologists. Lord, be with them all. Lord, in your mercy. For all victims and wounded in shooting events, especially in Kansas City, Willowbrook, Saginaw. Lord, in your mercy. For cleanup and recovery following tornadoes in Pennsylvania, New Jersey, and Indiana. Lord, in your mercy. For firefighters and all in the paths of brush fires in California and Arizona, and also in Canada, the many, many fires that are there. Lord, in your mercy. For peace in the world, especially in Ukraine, Palestine, and Syria, Lord, in your mercy. We lift up on this day, this 4th of July weekend, all those who are on our prayer list who are serving our country. We lift up Julian, Brittany, Brian, Justin, Jason, Jeremy, Connor, Bill, Jake, Brennan, Chris, Samantha, Brandon, Calistita. Lord, in your mercy, offer your protecting arms around them as they serve our country and help us hold on to the freedoms that we have. Lord, in your mercy. Into your hands, gracious God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. All right, I'd like you guys to bring up the welcome sign. Can you bring it up? Can all of you kind of take a little hand in it and help bring it forward? And bring it right up here, and let's put it right here. Wow, look at how beautiful this is. Thank you so much. This is so welcoming. Thank you. You can go back and sit with your parents now. Oh, be careful, honey. Let us prepare our hearts now as we get ready to enter into the great Thanksgiving. And let us pray. Good and gracious God, we give you praise and thanks for this meal of forgiveness, this meal of love, this meal of hope. Lord God, as we partake in this meal, may it cleanse us. May we be refreshed. And may we be sent out in your name. We pray. Amen. On the night in which our Lord Jesus was betrayed, he took bread and he gave thanks. And he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And after supper, he took the cup and he gave thanks. And he gave it for his disciples to drink. And he said, "This cup is the new covenant of my blood shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Come, taste and see that the Lord is good.
I've got a friend closer than a brother. There is no judgment. Oh, how he loves me. I've got a friend, and he is my strength. He is my portion. With me in the valley, with me in the fire, with me in the storm. Let all my life testify, hallelujah, we are not alone. God really loves us. God really loves us. Oh, oh, praise my soul. God really loves us. God really loves us. His mercy's enough. His grace is sufficient. So come if you're needing forgiveness and healing. His mercy's enough. Oh, and this is our hope. The cross, it has spoken. Death is no more. Christ is the Lord. And this is our hope. Hallelujah. We are not alone. God really loves us. God really loves us. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, praise my soul. God really loves us. God really loves us. Oh, and sing, oh, 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 what a father, what a friend, what a savior he is. What a father, what a friend, what a savior he is. Hallelujah, we are not alone. God really loves us. God really, he really loves us. Hallelujah. Whoa, praise my soul. God really loves us. God really loves us. Oh, oh.
Let us pray. God of abundance, with this bread of life and cup of salvation, you have united us with Christ, making us one with all your people. Now send us forth in the power of your Spirit, that we may proclaim your redeeming love to the world and continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please stand. And now the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine upon you with grace and mercy, and the Lord bring you peace. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amazing grace would bear my cross. Clap your hands with us. Let's praise the Lord as we go.
Who breaks the power of sin and darkness? Whose love is mighty and so much stronger? The King of glory, the King above all kings. Who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder and leaves us breathless in awe and wonder? The King of glory, the King above all kings. Yes, this is amazing grace. Says unfailing love that you would take my place, that you would bear my cross. You laid down your life that I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Chaos back into order. Who makes the orphan a son and daughter? The King of glory, the King of glory. Who rules the nations with truth and justice, shines as the sun in all of its brilliance. The King of glory, the King above all kings. Yes, this is amazing grace. This is unfailing love that you would take my place, that you would bear my cross. You laid down your life that I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Yes, this is amazing grace. This is unfailing love that you would take my place, that you would bear my cross. You laid down your life that I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me.
Welcome others with a fist bump, a high five, and an elbow bump, and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.